Hey everyone, it's Kato, and in today's video, we're going to be talking about two of the most frequently asked questions that I get while I'm streaming. So if you're interested in content like this and you want to see more in the future, I'd appreciate if you like and subscribe, but let's just get right into it. So I'm not even going to make you wait, I'm just going to jump in to this first question because it is probably the most frequently asked question that I get in my streams, on my videos. And that is, how do you have two islands? Or can I have multiple islands on one Switch? And I hate to be the bearer of bad news.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
But you cannot have more than one island on one Switch. I do in fact have two Switches. So currently I have two different islands that I'm working on simultaneously, and that is how you see different islands, different content on my channel. I wish that Nintendo would implement a feature where we could have multiple islands on one Switch. I don't envision them doing that. So that is the answer to the first question of, can I have multiple islands? Unfortunately, it is no. I would love to know down in the comments, if you were able to have more than one island on your Switch, would you have two islands? How many would you want? Definitely leave that down in the comments below. I'm just curious. Moving forward to the second question that I get asked very frequently. And I get asked this when I am time traveling, because when I go to my home screen, there is an app next to my Animal Crossing game, and people want to know, what is that app? It's super cute. It's got a little Nook cardboard box on it. I would be curious about it too if I didn't already know what it was. And all this app is the Animal Crossing New Horizons Island Transfer Tool. And this is actually how you move your island from one Switch to another. So I actually fairly recently got the Animal Crossing Edition Switch. And when I got that Switch, I wanted to transfer my island from one Switch to another so I could have my island on that Switch, if that makes any sense. This app is really beneficial for anyone who is upgrading their Switch, transitioning from a Switch to a Switch Lite. Maybe one day we will get a Switch Pro and we'll be able to transfer our islands from our current Switches to our Switch Pro. But this is definitely an upgrade in the transferring process from what it was previously, where you had to actually contact Nintendo to transfer your island over, and you were limited to one transfer. So you have to download the Island Transfer Tool to do this. So I'm actually going to show you today, if you're planning on transferring an island over, I'm just going to show you a quick little tutorial here on how easy it is to do. If you have any questions about it, hopefully this video will answer those questions for you. First thing you need to do, you need to open up your Animal Crossing game, and when you're on that title screen, you're actually going to hit the minus button on your left Joy-Con or on your Pro Controller. There should be a little minus button on there. You're going to hit that, and Tom Nook is going to appear, and this is where you actually access your settings for Animal Crossing. And once Tom Nook appears, you're actually going to see a list of different options that you can access through your settings. The one that we're going to be talking about today is the island backup setting. So you're going to want to make sure that you click on this island backup and that you have it enabled. This is what's actually going to create your save data, put it into the cloud, and allow you to transfer it from one Switch to another Switch. So you're going to click on Island Backup. If it's not already enabled, you would see an option here to enable it. Because mine is already enabled, it gives me the option to disable it, which I don't want to do today, but I just wanted to point this out before we move on to the next step. The next thing is just downloading the app itself. So what you're going to want to do, you're going to want to access your eShop down at the bottom of your home screen, open it up, and you can just quickly go to the search bar, start typing in Island Transfer Tool, and once you start typing it, it'll actually pop up as a predictive text option. You can just click on that and the app will pop up for you to download. It is a free download. Mine is already grayed out as purchased because I already have it downloaded on my Switch. But if you didn't already have it, you would just click purchase right there, but it is free, so you don't have to worry about that. You're just going to want to download this app right here. Super easy to do, and it downloads very fast too. I do want to point out that you need to have this app downloaded on both of the Switches. So that is the Source Switch, which has your Animal Crossing data on it, and also the Target Switch, which is the one you're going to be moving the data to. You need to have the app downloaded on both, and you're going to go ahead and open it up on both Switches at this point. Once you have it open on both Switches, you're just going to read through these instructions here. It's just telling you about the save data transfer process, how it's going to take some time to transfer over, and you're probably going to need to plug in your Switch to a power source so it doesn't run out of battery while you're trying to download the new save file. So then you need to select on each respective Switch which one is the Source Switch, so the one that has the data on it, and which one is the Target Switch, which is the one that you want to transfer the data to. And then it'll pop up with the save data for your island that's on that Switch, and you're just going to hit yes, we do want to transfer this over. Then on the other Switch, you're just going to want to hit the proceed button. And finally, you're going to get a prompt on your Source Switch. Do you want to transfer the data over? And you just hit transfer data, and this will start that process for you. When I did this, it was actually really quick. It probably took about 2 minutes to transfer my data, and I was expecting it to take much longer than that. And once you've done that, you are finished. You will be able to open your island up on your other Switch. I also want to mention that you are able to transfer the data again. So to do this video, I transferred it from one Switch to another, and then I transferred it right back. Super easy, no issues. I was able to open up my game, no problem. The fact that they made this app and they made it a much simpler process to transfer your save data is something that should have been implemented from the beginning. I don't know why it wasn't, but I am really glad they added this. I don't think we would need this feature if we could just have more than one island on a Switch, but some people are getting new Switches, upgrading their Switches, maybe switching over to a Switch Lite. So there is a use for this app, and I hope this answers all of your questions about the Island Transfer Tool, which is that little cute app that you see next to my Animal Crossing New Horizons game when I'm time traveling. If you do have any other questions, feel free to leave them down in the comments, and I will do my best to get to as many as I can. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial style video. If you did, I'd appreciate if you'd like and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye.